where I sit, we're all a gift. Everybody learns a little differently, so there can't be just one way to teach. All I ask for is a little of your help, and I can shine as bright as anybody else. We can do this from where I sit.
I found out I had a learning disability in my late 20s. You know, I didn't read. I just hated reading. My mind wanders. You know, I'm not good in testing.
I actually do an assessment of the instructor. His teaching style is not conducive to my learning style, then it's not a match.
My disabilities are many, and they're unseen. I live in pain every day. Memory loss. The anthrax caused a whole bunch of things.
Handouts were with all these smudges and lines and wrinkles. If it's not clean, it should be retyped.
Teachers often forget about leaving a light on, shining to the interpreter so you can still see.
Ordering books in electronic text or alternate format takes 4 to 6 weeks.
I have teachers who have suggested that I sit in the back. And that's difficult because the students who talk during class, they sit in the back.
Please allow me to choose my own seat. Could you face the class when you speak? If I ask you to repeat something, know that there's a reason why. I might not hear as well as she does. I might not see as well as he does. But I am not lazy, far from it. You can count on me to try. From where I sit, we're all a gift. Everybody learns a little differently, so there can't be just one way to teach. All I ask for is a little.
Program that allows you to scan your books on the scanner and it plops up on the computer screen and then the computer reads to you.
We need to be able to get our books ahead of time.
The disability services on campus needs to take it apart from the spine and scan individual pages, and scanning is not 100% accurate, so there's quite a bit of editing that needs to be done.
To use faculty as a resource. For example, if you know a student wants a textbook, you need to scan it, you need it in advance, and you can't get it from the publisher, call the faculty member.
Sitting in a classroom, it's painful. I have a short attention span. I try to sit up front so I can stare the teacher in the eye, so I can make sure I'm trying to listen, but it's sometimes hard to grasp what they're saying because I get it mixed up.
From the vantage point of the professor, if you don't know the student, it's impossible to tell whether this is a student who is like, oh man, what do I need this class for? You know, just with an attitude, or whether it's a student who is struggling, like this woman is, to overcome something.
Get me materials ahead of time. Try to put your notes online. You are a partner in this dream of mine. In this dream.
One teacher I enjoy going to his class is because he taught in a way I think he was teaching for everybody. It wasn't a lot of lecture class, but, you know, he gave you assignment and he made sure he had that one-on-one.
Just going from PowerPoint to PowerPoint is not enough. Sometimes it's enough to know that there's some sensitivity and, if I can use the word, love from the professor's vantage.
Rather than handouts, visuals, being more creative in the classroom.
I love online classes because you have a week or two to complete assignments.
I've had a bunch of teachers that have actually worked very well with bringing the classroom into a circle, and other students like it a lot more too, and it involves the students more.
Yes, people learn differently. Well, what are some of the options that the instructor might have for presenting material in different ways?
So with our resources and our class sizes, I mean, I'm starting to feel like, how can I possibly do this? And how can you organize a class? And how can...
From where I sit, we're all a gift. Everybody learns a little differently. So there can't be just one way to teach. All I ask for is a little of your help, and I can shine as bright as anybody else. This is my wish. We can do this from where I sit. Where I am.